Night, many East Berliners simply didn't believe that the borders were opening.
I mean, the East Berliners are coming over here in droves. There's somebody climbing up with a hammer and taking bits and pieces away.
The Iron Curtain opened in East Berlin tonight.
With the Iron Curtain crumbling, that last wall is crumbling.
Change in the political landscape of Eastern Europe.
We are standing in attendance at a moment in history.
On August 13th, 1961, thousands of soldiers from the Soviet embassy poured into East Berlin with the sole intention of dividing the city in half. A crude barrier of barbed wire first divided the British, French, and American sectors from the Soviet Union one. It soon became apparent that a permanent wall was being placed, as concrete blocks divided famous boulevards, stores, parks, and even homes. This came as a cold shock to many Germans. Eastern President Walter Ulbricht had given no warning to the people of Berlin or the West. Wall was built as a crude solution to prevent East Germans from escaping to the capitalist West. This had become a bigger problem for East Germany, as both educated and manual workers fled. Trains had stopped running, telephone lines had been cut, there was virtually no communication between East and West Germany.
Through this wall broke families apart and destroyed lives. People died on the wall.
Through the summer of 1961, there were extraordinary feats to get to the other side, even though escapees knew that the guards were ordered to shoot. Willy Brandt, the mayor of West Berlin, was deeply disappointed that NATO, and more specifically the United States, had not responded more quickly and vigorously to the building of the wall. This fueled a lot of anti-American sentiment in West Germany. They had felt abandoned by an ally and a friend until 22 months later, President Kennedy gave his famous Ich bin Berliner speech at Brandenburg Gate.
All free men, wherever they may live, are citizens of Berlin. And therefore, as a free man, I take pride in the words, Ich bin ein Berliner.
As people continue escaping, the wall is reinforced with automatic guns and mines. Meanwhile, in West Germany, capitalism thrived, and the city was able to rebuild itself from the ruins of World War II. The throbbing, cosmopolitan feel of the city was in stark contrast to the drab, boring streets of East Berlin. The arts, free expression, and individuality were encouraged, as well as other Western values. Fear of a nuclear war continues as the Soviet Union places nuclear bombs in East Germany. NATO retaliates by placing nuclear bombs in West Germany. Still, thousands of people were escaping every year, and General Secretary Erich Honecker had the wall built even higher. Towers were new and improved, higher and even more deadly. There were gigantic 3-ton slabs of concrete pushed up against the original wall. This would make digging under the wall impossible. Also, there were rounded blocks placed on top of the wall to prevent people from climbing over. The roundedness of the concrete made it impossible to hold. Some say that the calm, untouched walls on the East Berlin side clearly represented the East Berlin lifestyle, clean and safe.
The restrictions to go to other socialistic countries has been even bolder.
In reality, this just showed how the East German government did not let its population express itself in any way that wouldn't want them to without facing fear of political prison.
You can't put people in a cage. They will fight for their liberty.
Things begin to change in Eastern Europe with the incoming of solidarity by Poland leader Lech Walesa. Soon after, Czechoslovakia has their own peaceful revolution against the Soviet Empire. When the electrified fence between Austria and Hungary is turned off and the borders opened, thousands of East Germans flee, using this border as a crossing way into the free land. They abandon their cars and belongings on the side of the road, only taking their clothes on their backs.
So, just to show you the borders of the wall. So, here, the train from Dresden over the border to Czechoslovakia, which is now two different states, which is called Czech Republic and Slovakia. We went through this former Czechoslovakia for 13 hours, and then we went to Hungary, Budapest, which is the capital of Hungary, and there we stayed. And from there, we tried to escape. We went here to this border. We tried it in 5 different points at this border. It was raining outside and we had to crawl through a field, and we knew there's border control on the left and on the right side, but we somehow made it into Austria, and Austria is a democratic country. It's a free country. It's behind the Iron Wall on the right side.
In 1985, Mikhail Gorbachev was chosen first secretary of the Soviet Communist Party.
And in East Germany, nothing would have ever happened in most of Eastern Europe if it hadn't been for the arrival of one man, and that was Gorbachev.
Seeing that the economies of Eastern Europe were crumbling, Gorbachev introduced perestroika, letting them have much more independence with their money.
Mr. Gorbachev, open this gate.
20 years old, I went for the first time to Spain and saw a real palm tree, and that was kind of a huge liberation, because I was finally there where I wanted to be.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Euro spokesman Gunter Schabowski announces on November the 9th, 1989, that for the first time, East German citizens can travel abroad freely. A journalist asks him when. He answers, at once. It was a mistake. He should have said tomorrow. The news spreads like wildfire.
Berlin Wall, where hundreds of people have climbed on top of it.
4 o'clock in the morning.
Nothing will be as it was before.
All East and West Germans have come to the wall to celebrate the end of fear.
As a direct result, Bosnia, Croatia, Slovakia, the Czech Republic, and Poland all had their own peaceful revolutions and became independent nations. This was a major turning point in the power of communism in Eastern Europe. The Cold War that had haunted the world was finally over.
At the stroke of midnight, German time, the two countries formally became one.
Reporting live from Berlin.
The greatest day from Germany!
The official building, the first act of a fully sovereign Germany of almost 80 million people, the most powerful country in Europe.
I wasn't sure if I see my mom ever again, so I wrote her a long letter about my escape, how it was, and she cried because she knew. She thought in this very moment she has lost her daughter, and it was very emotional. Berlin Wall is very important. It was a turning point in my life. Everything. I mean, it is still. You shouldn't forget about history. Every nation should not forget about history.